Today's review will be Hasegawa's Lamborghini Miura P400SV chassis number 5030, the gold restoration. You can make this exact one if you go online and Google Lamborghini Miura chassis number 5030. You'll see reference pictures on inside. It's got the gold body with the silver bottom, and it's got an all black interior. So that's what I will be doing mine as. This was sent over by the folks at Model Roundup. They've got this one in the 1/24th scale. They've got a whole bunch of Hasegawa kits, some with cool little figures in 1/24th scale, some very sexy lady figures, and all that kind of cool stuff. So head on over there. I will link down in the description where you can snatch this one. But first, let's take a look at everything that's in the box when you get yours. First up will be the molded in the nice gold color body. That is a very nice, I don't see any flash, any hang-offs, nothing. Nothing needs to be corrected or messed with. There are some light swirl marks in my body. Now, normally that wouldn't bug me, but since I have to paint the bottom silver anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and throw a different color of gold on there. It's a mix between this body and the Lamborghini color. It won't be exact, but it'll be my model. You don't have to paint yours. You could always future floor polish that or leave it as it is because it's extremely glossy just as it is out of the box. We've got three black sprues, and this one should be easy. All I'm going to do is get a little paint on them to remove the plastic look. We've got our engine, what looks like the air cleaners for the engine from what I was Googling. We got suspension arms, back glass, the divider between the engine and the cockpit. We got steerable steering. We got a set of four disc brakes, parts of the front suspension, links, looks like license plate frames. You can tell it's definitely a steerable suspension when they've got the little snaps on either end to go on the little snap ends right there. You can always tell a lot of these 1/24th Japanese kits, they like to do that. Here's the bottom of the chassis. We'll be painting that to get that plastic sheen off of it. We've got engine parts, suspension, the louvers for the back of the car over where the engine is. Let's turn it around. You can see those are molded open, but you really can't see anything through them but the air cleaners, so we'll discuss that later. We got our inner fenders on the rear of the car. We've got the sides of the engine, which of course sits in the back of the car, being a Lamborghini, and more suspension there. The last parts up are the nice looking interior. We got an interior pan. We've got a beautiful dashboard. We've got the top of the dashboard right there. Flipping the tree around because of all the details on different sections. We got some grates here. I'm not sure what they're for, but we'll get to building those up. We've got the nice looking grill insert. We've got our exhaust system. We can get that painted. It's one large piece crossover. We got the nice bucket seats. In real life, they are that black color. They look just like that. We got more exhaust pieces. We've got some venting, some ducting. What these parts are, go to the bottom of the body and form that part right there. Now let's switch over to the table. Grab the clear parts. We got our windshield and our side glass, so the windows are closed on this one. If you wanted, you could carefully cut that so your doors can be open. We've got our little side markers. Very small pieces, but they're on there. We got that glass so that from the cockpit you can see out those louvers and without getting the heat of the engine. We got some nice window glass or headlights, turn signals, tail lights. We'll be able to accentuate these with clear paints or with markers. We've got a large chrome tree. Wheels, we've got these little vents here. These are actually these parts here, which is another reason I'll be painting the body to blend those in to the body. We've got the front bumper here, the front grille here, which on this one will be black, so that will be painted. We got headlight bezels and headlight surrounds, which are supposed to be chrome. We've got windshield wipers, which are supposed to be metallic. We've got knockoffs for the wheel, rearview mirror, antenna. We got carburation for the engine and some other small parts, looks like mirrors or lights on there. We've got two sheets of decals. One are these beautiful chrome metallic ones. We got a shift gate, looks like gauge bezels, nameplates, all kinds of nice stuff on there. I left it in the bag because sometimes those will fall off the sheet. We've got water slides here. These eyebrow looking things here. It's so that you don't have to try to paint inside where the headlights go. That's what those are right there. We've got Lamborghini logos, Miura logos. We've got gauges to make our life easier on that dashboard along with these bezels. Ought to be a lot easier to get that done on the interior, draw a little attention. We've got some white Lamborghini logos down here if you do a dark colored car. We got what looks like possible center caps, Lamborghini logos with those gauges and those headlights surround. So it's a nice decal sheet. And finally, in the box, four real rubber tires, four poly caps to get those wheels on. Beautiful tread design. We've got big and littles for front and rear. No names on the sidewall that I can see whatsoever on either set of tires, but they are solid and they have a nice tread pattern on them. Those are all the parts that are in the box. I'm gonna start putting together the very first Lamborghini on the channel and I'll be right back. All right, first up, since this is my first Hasegawa model that I can remember on the show, I might have done others, I can tell you that their manuals are crisp and concise and well-drawn and tell you exactly where things should go. There is no misidentification or stuff like that, and they even have really nice sidebars telling you what color to paint everything. So that aside, assembly went super easy. It is well-designed. I've got the trees split up in the ways that I want to paint things. The wheels, the carburation, the knockoffs on the box art and in the real life, they are not a chrome color. So what I'm gonna do is use a matte coat on all of these, just a clear matte, and then I will highlight them with a black wash and that will give me that look that I'm going for with these wheels. So those are all set to go on the side. This part of the chrome tree, the front grille should be all black on mine, so I will be painting that black. These parts here, the air cleaners on top of the carburetors. The top of the air cleaners is a silver color, so I will be spraying the interior door panels, the brakes, and the air cleaners with flat black, and then I will be hand painting details on all these and using a metallic gel pen to do the little silver accents on the door panels before we're done. The louvers should be black, but not black plastic, so I will be painting them and getting them a coat of paint. I've got the seats, the rear grille. These ended up being the two grills. I was wondering what they were in the beginning, the two grills in the front of the boot. And then this looks like it is the radiator or something underneath that, or the radiator tank or something that goes right underneath that. So I'll be painting all those up to get that plastic look off of them and detailing them. Our exhaust, of course, won't be black. It'll be a metallic color, and that's why they're cut free from other items. We've got our nice little steering wheel package. It is black with chrome metallic spokes on the steering wheel. So again, we'll get that painted. I'll hand detail that. Hand painting doesn't bother me at all. The dashboard's supposed to be black. We've got numerous dash decals. We've got some buttons here. And then we've got all those trim rings to put on and detail that dashboard for us. So we'll get some paint on that. These parts here are the headrests that mount along the back of the interior and a roof console of the car. We'll get some paint on those just to knock down the plastic look. This is our interior. All this stuff is black except for some silver accents we'll do with a silver gel pen or the accent decals that they provide, like for the shifter and all that. So we've got that. We've got this back glass frame. We need to put the glass in it when we're all done. I'll get this painted up with a flat black, and then I will gloss coat the center console, as you'll see, and that'll bring it out much different than the interior pieces, and it's an easy thing to do without having a mask off or anything. Then we'll insert the glass that looks over that V12 engine, and we'll be all set. The body needed these vents installed, which are molded in black, and these vents on top, which are in chrome, installed on the sides and the back. Now this one is the proper size for that vent. This one's a little short. It is not in the box. I assume it was a short shot. So that will just be left like that. We'll take all of our pictures from this side and no one will ever know. And I'm not building for a show, so I don't really worry about it. These are the headlight buckets in the bottom. I can glue those in now, get them some paint on them. Also, your headlights can go up or down. You can mount them either way. So I'll be mounting mine flush. I like the daytime sleek look of it, but you can also mount them up using that type of a mount like that. And we are all set to go. So you can see all those glue on and fit very nicely into both sides of the body and key in, and they come up a little bit to create that parallel scoop there. Looks very nice, and we'll be painting the body. So that is that. We've got the chassis here ready to go. As you can see, the only part of the engine, once we have the fenders and the top of the engine on, is that you really can't see anything else. I mean, that's it. So I am going to take that engine cover off, get it painted. This stuff I'm not going to worry about. The sides of the engine and all the other details on there. The bottom of the chassis is beautifully detailed. I will be painting this area silver. And then the rest I'm going to be doing an oil rubbed bronze color to kind of make it look like a metallic painted metal. Got our front suspension, sway bars, and I left the front suspension steering because it was so easy to do on this kit. I got a nice little thumbprint, so for the rest of the world, whenever they find this kit 1,000 years from now, none of this is seen whatsoever, so I didn't try to remove that thumbprint. I wasn't worried about it. Underside will get painted after we do that oil rubbed bronze color. I will get that painted silver, and I will get the bottom of the transmission painted silver. We're not going to see the rest. The engine cover and the fenders will get a coat of black. Then I will go in and paint the top of the engine with a steel color, a metallic color. Then we can put our carburation and our air cleaners painted on the top, and that'll look nice. And if you can see anything through those louvers, I'd be surprised. But if you can somehow get a sneak peek, you'll be able to see that little bit of detail underneath there, and that's more than enough for me. So we're gonna hit the paint booth, and I'll be right back. I always like kits that don't require a massive amount of work to get the nice details that you want, and this one certainly is that way. Take a look at that chassis. Nice basic. I love that oil rub bronze look on there. I use that a lot on sports cars. It's like it's a black, but it's got a little bit of a sheen to it. It's really cool looking. See the nice looking exhaust coming out the back, the bottom of the engine there. The pan down there looks nice with that testers on there. We got the brakes mounted. Those look lovely behind there. Up underneath, we can just see, we won't be able to see any of this really once the car's together. I'll take a close look when I'm done, but I just detailed that top there so you guys could see it. And the fenders cover everything on the side. So those are all set to go. We got the brakes with our gold calipers, because I decided a gold car should have gold calipers. That was the decision. How awesome do those wheels look? Those came out real nice. I used that Tamiya gray wash on the inside so that it looks much more similar to the box art with that darker gray on the inside of the wheels. That turned out super nice. Show you the back too, but the back is still chrome because you're really never going to see it. Make sure when you put them on the car, you put the fat tires in the back and the skinnier tires in the front. I sanded them down. That just simulates like it had actually been used, driven, you know, a few feet at least in the real world. We got the nice body all set up. All the vents are glued in, the louvers are glued in, the glass is glued in. I darkened in the vents with Tamiya black wash. We got our side vents on there. We got the awesome looking little tail lights and the back grille on there. Not much to do on that body. The headlights will go in. They do fit extremely loose because you're supposed to be able to, of course, mount them standing up or down. I'm going to have them mounting down on mine, but you can also change the look all the time and have it sit up. I'm going to try to do it with just a couple hands here. You can position them so that they sit in the upright position. They're going to look a little weird without the black decals around the headlights right now. So I left those out till the end. I'll be laying mine down and just leaving it that way. And that's that. We don't have much. We have got the knockoffs to put on the wheels. We've got the windshield wipers to install. We've got the exhaust tips to install, which I used a black wash on the inside of, the Tamiya black wash that I use. We've got to put the headlight surround decals on. We've got to put some nameplate decals on and the hood ornament, just some very minor work on the sides of the car, the nose, and the tail of the car. Speaking of the nose, you can see with the grill in there, and the clear lights in the front. So that's all set. And then we've got the interior tub. The white here is from Activator on the super glue. You can see how nice that turns out with the contrasting black. You can see the glass behind the seats there. And that dashboard looks real nice. All the trim rings, all the decals went on. So we are all set. That's an all black interior. Of course, when you do yours, you don't have to do it in gold just because it comes that way. You can do it with a leather interior, and you can do it with the horse grain or whatever they called it inside with that darker, redder leather. You can do whatever you want, a different color body. I've seen some oranges and some yellows. They're all cool looking. So I just decided to replicate the box art on mine. So I will do all that little minor work, pushing the wheels on, putting the interior in, snapping the body, and the decals, maybe at the most an hour worth of work left, and I'll be right back. Hasegawa's 1/24th scale limited edition Lamborghini Miura P400SV, chassis number 5030, gold restoration. Look at that. They had to make the box a foot wider just to fit that entire name on there. But we are all done with this kit, and what a pleasure to build it. Sent over by the cool peeps at Model Roundup. They've got all kinds of these 124th Japanese-made exotic car models for you to build up. Of course, they all got tons of stuff, but I will link this particular one. You can go to their website. You can search Hasegawa, Aoshima, Tamiya. They've got all kinds of stuff that a lot of hobby shops don't carry. Completely licensed by Lamborghini, and a beautiful model. If you've ever watched Jay Leno's Garage, he's got like three or four of these parked in there. He says they're absolutely awesome, and that guy is the foremost authority on cars. It is an easy build. You even get a little bit of an engine, so if you somehow wanted to cut open the back hatch and open it up, you know, you cut along the sides and fold the whole thing up like the real car, you could do so, and you would have the engine underneath there to look at. It's very nice looking. We can look underneath. All you can really see is the bottom of the chassis and the exhaust. There isn't much else to look at underneath there, but it is detailed enough to make a beautiful curbside model. Like I said, if you look through the louvers, you can just make out the engine through there. So at least I put it in there and did a little detailing, and you can see it. I love how easy it is to do those taillights. I thought they might be a pain being tricolor lights, but they worked out. The wheels look gorgeous with that gray wash inside. They look just like the real thing on the box. The interior is easy to work on and very easy to detail with 8 decals for the gauges. They've got the metal trim rings if you want to use them. They've got the metal shift gate, all that kind of cool stuff. They got the little vents on the side, the vents on the bottom. We've got that two-tone paint going on. They've got all the emblems for you, and everything just kind of pushes together with a little bit of glue and no problem. I'm really glad they included the decals for around the headlights, and they went on super smooth. They're shaped properly, and they just fell into place without a second of trouble. The vents go in lovely. The hood ornament goes on. The front bumper is just pushed in. The grill bumper area with the turn signals is just pushed in with a friction fit, and it all goes in. The holes are drilled for the windshield wipers. It's all super easy, so this could easily be a first kit for a person if they wanted to experiment with glue kits, and they love Lamborghinis, the older ones. This would be easy to do if you want to put an exotic on the shelf. So as always, I thank Model Roundup for sending this over. They said, hey, we're getting a bunch of these cool new kits. Which one do you want? I picked this one, and I'm glad I did. They also have ones with female figures to stand next to them in the same scale. Those look pretty cool. Maybe I'll try one of those next. So as always, thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks to our cool sponsor, ModelRoundup.com. I'll link in the description where to get this exact model that they have in stock right now. Build for you. Have a good time with your hobby. Smile. It's supposed to be a great pastime. See you at the next review.